Today marks the pinnacle for these high school graduates, the second classroom of their senior year. The atmosphere is charged with tension and anxiety as they face the impending awakening trial, an assessment that elicits mixed emotions among them, akin to a college entrance exam in our world. Chung, our protagonist, awoke abruptly, jolted from an afternoon nap. Anxious whispers surrounded him as a boy nervously nudged him, interrupting what seemed like a joyful reprieve. Chung's eyes fluttered open, transitioning from the haze of sleep to the surprise of unfamiliar surroundings, a classroom filled with buzzing chatter. Suddenly on his feet, drenched in cold sweat, panic lacing his voice, Chung questioned, "Where am I?" A rush of memories flooded back. The planet beneath him, Blue Star, mirrored Earth with modernized cities, familiar streets, and existing nations. Chung pondered if this was a parallel universe, a catastrophic event a century prior had unleashed vicious monsters wreaking havoc on humanity. The people of Blue Star possessed innate talents, awakened through a trial, a crucial step unlocking paths to professions like assassins, mages, hunters, warriors, or support. Failing the trial meant a mediocre life, widening the already stark divide between the awakened and others in wealth and social status. The world focused on nurturing awakened elites, and tomorrow marked the day Chung and his peers would face the awakening trial. In this world, the awakened held unimaginable wealth, formidable abilities, and countless followers. Amidst the bizarre circumstances, Chung realized the plot unfolding before him felt eerily familiar, like the game he once played, Genesis. Genesis, the most popular open-world MMORPG, had been a global phenomenon. As Chung grappled with the surreal situation, he pieced together that he had somehow transitioned into a reality that mirrored the game. In his previous life on Earth, in the virtual world of Genesis, he played a warrior class reaching level 999, a breath away from ultimate victory. A veteran of countless battles, he had earned the title of the ultimate war god. Yet, as Chung delved into his memories, he knew things had not gone entirely well. Before we continue, take a moment to answer the question of the day. Chinese or Korean Manhwa? Comment down below for a chance to be shouted out. Now, back to the recap. After defeating countless monsters, he finally arrived at the final room. What held him back was the cooldowns on his skills and the lack of damage. He was swarmed by an endless horde of monsters summoned by the final boss, just mere steps away from the ultimate showdown. Between them stood hundreds of powerful elite monsters. He was exhausted, his health and mana depleted, and his equipment shattered. Defeated and kneeling on the ground, his vision blurred as he was overwhelmed by the horde of monsters. Seeing the large letters of defeat on his monitor angered him, and he pounded his keyboard, frustrated and unwilling to accept this end. What followed up was the screen glowing with the red words of death. He was so close yet so far, and the next thing he knew, he was isekai'd into this world. Chung's reverie was interrupted by a chubby student sitting next to him, who nudged him. Anxious and tearing his hair out, Chung turned to Lee Hong, questioning why he was daydreaming. Hong said Chung, turning to Lee Hong, whose nickname was Lee Hong. Looking surprised, Chung exclaimed and called out Lee Hong's name. Just like in his past life, Lee Hong was his loyal friend and the best buddy during their time in school. Looking at Lee Hong's familiar face and sensing his nervousness, Chung suddenly felt this world had its own charm. He gripped Lee Hong's shoulder, expressing disbelief at seeing him in this world too. Lee Hong, a bit startled, didn't understand what Chung was talking about and thought he was joking. Seeing Chung's relaxed demeanor made him even more anxious. Lee Hong knew Chung was smart and always did well in school, but he himself was fraught with worry. Grabbing his hair, he became even more anxious. Chung smiled, reminiscing that in this world, Lee Hong's looks and personality remained unchanged. It seemed his relationships and life in this new world weren't much different from before. Lee Hong looked at his best friend Chung with tears welling up in his eyes. Clutching Chung, he broke down, revealing his dread for the upcoming awakening trial. It was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and failing the assessment would not only be a personal disaster, but would also mean facing his father's wrath. Chung, recalling his past experiences in the game, remembered that the term awakening referred to players touching the awakening stone in the assessment's secret realm. It was the only way to activate a person's innate talent. However, he wondered if it was the same here. After getting to know more, it seemed this world operated on similar principles. Lee Hong whispered into Chung's ear, begging for his help in the upcoming trial. With a smile, Chung asked how Lee Hong wanted him to help. Lee Hong, with a comedic expression, said he didn't need to shoot for the stars. He just needed to do the bare minimum to satisfy his father. Knowing Chung's cleverness and resourcefulness, Lee Hong wondered if he could pull off a last-minute miracle. Although Chung had inherited a wealth of memories, he knew that the game's tricks and strategies might not fully apply in this new reality. The extent to which this world mirrored the game, and why he was here were mysteries he needed to unravel himself. Standing up, Chung reassured Li Hong that he could count on him. He decided to visit the practice arena to figure something out. As he left the classroom, Li Hong, filled with newfound hope, shouted after his best friend. He even said that if Chung could pull this off, the entire year's lunch would be on him. With a cool gesture, Chung left, determined to find a way to help his friend in this strange yet familiar world. Chung swiftly arrived at the practice arena, a vast space bustling with students. In the center stood a shimmering oval-shaped portal, constantly radiating white light, where students continuously entered and exited the practice secret realm. It was a lively atmosphere, with several staff and teachers present to maintain order. Approaching the portal, Chung observed various students discussing strategies. Some debated that they should have gone for the easier mobs first, while others argued it was a waste of time and mana. Another party of two supporting each other exited the portal, looking utterly exhausted. Taking a deep breath, Chung was eager to see what this amalgamation of game and reality had in store. He smiled and stepped into the portal. A flash of white light transformed his surroundings. No longer in the practice arena, Chung found himself in a forest facing a suspension bridge leading to a small village. The setting was sunny, complete with the chirping of birds. Scanning the area, Chung was stunned. It was the beginner village from the game, replicated perfectly down to the last detail. But his surprise didn't end there. A mechanical voice rang in his head. System detecting host binding transformation. System progress. 50%, 70%, 100%. Binding successful. Chung puzzled, wondering what exactly this transformation system was. To answer his question, a window appeared, confirming the successful binding of the transformation system, currently at level 1. It was quite a shocker to acquire a system in Isekai. Oof. Shocker right anyway. Reading through the system's description, Chung discovered that the transformation system could convert two active skills with specific conditions into an extra passive skill. The power of this passive skill was enhanced by the character's primary attributes. Baffled yet intrigued by this functionality, Chung thought about the dynamics of the game. Genesis, where active skills were predominant and passive skills were a rare commodity. Active skills had cooldowns and couldn't be triggered indefinitely, while passive skills were always present, depending on trigger probabilities. Higher levels of passive skills meant higher trigger probabilities. Chung clenched his fists, reminiscing about his previous inability to defeat the final boss due to skill cooldown restrictions. Now, with this passive transformation system, he hoped to overcome that shortfall. Carefully, Chung opened his skill panel, greeted by a row of familiar skill icons. The system prompted him to choose a skill to transform. His options included Uppercut, Wave Slash, Slide Tackle, and Weapon Switch. Chung decided to transform Wave Slash first. Upon his selection, a sword materialized in his hand, accompanied by a system notification, Wave Slash Level 1. Acquired, a powerful upward strike that releases a wave, an AoE skill attacking and knocking back enemies. The skill then transformed and granted him a new passive ability, a 30% chance of triggering another Wave Slash, dealing more damage and granting the user 0.2 seconds of invincibility. It was good, but not broken. Chung, initially surprised, swung his new sword a few times, marveling at the new passive ability and the significant damage boost. Now, the real game begins. Just then, he heard footsteps and heavy breathing from behind. Looking up, he saw a massive minotaur approaching. The creature, missing one horn and bulging with muscles, wielded a giant axe, its bloodshot eyes fixed on Chung. Recognizing the beast as a level 3 minotaur, one of the more challenging foes in the beginner village, Chung readied his sword, eager for a real battle test. The minotaur bellowed, tongue lolling, and charged at Chung with its axe raised high. Chung didn't flinch. Instead, he readied his sword, triggering Wave Slash and sending a powerful purple wave that knocked the minotaur back several meters into a tall rock. Having exerted his full strength in that strike, Chung watched intently as the mist cleared. The minotaur rose unscathed, its eyes now glowing a fierce crimson. Enraged, it leapt into the air, appearing above Chung in an instant, and slammed its giant axe down. Chung dodged continuously, attempting counterattacks with his sword. Unfortunately, his current attributes were insufficient to defeat a minotaur in a berserk state. At that critical moment, Chung found himself cornered, with the minotaur's axe mere inches from his head. He raised his sword in a desperate attempt to block, but the inferior weapon stood no chance against the mighty axe. Shortly after, the sword shattered completely. However, in that split second, the passive Wave Slash triggered, granting Chung 0.2 seconds of invincibility. Without hesitation, Chung used the remnants of his broken sword to forcibly unleash Wave Slash, enhanced with a 1.5 times damage multiplier. He crouched and then thrust upward, stabbing fiercely from the minotaur's chin into its skull. The creature howled in agony, dropping its weapon and crashing once more into the distant rockery. After a brief struggle, it lay motionless, defeated, as the Minotaur's body dissolved into the ether. Chung's face lit up with an exhilarated smile. Looking at his hands, he realized that transforming his skills into passives not only solved the cooldown issue, but also significantly increased his damage output, addressing all his previous problems. Gazing at the distant sunset, a fiery resolve ignited within him. Clenching his fists, Chung resolved that in this world, he would rectify the regrets of his past life. Suddenly, a giant mantis monster appeared behind Chung. Reacting swiftly, he plunged his broken sword into the creature's head, causing green blood to spurt out. Chung then spun around 180 degrees, yanked the sword out, and kicked the mantis's corpse away. After hours of relentless combat, Chung was utterly exhausted, surrounding a large tree where the bodies of hundreds of different monsters he had defeated. Panting heavily, Chung examined his nearly shattered short sword, reflecting on the familiar sensation of battle from his past life. Having trained for hours in this realm, he felt confident about helping Li Hong awaken his talent in tomorrow's assessment. But first, he needed Li Hong to get him some intel about the assessment. The system suddenly reappeared, prompting Chung to select a second skill for passive transformation. Opening the skill interface again, Chung stroked his chin, contemplating his next choice. Considering that his shortcomings were insufficient attack power and long skill cooldowns, and having already chosen Wave Slash, Chung selected Weapon Switch for transformation. The system confirmed. Weapon Switch acquired. Initially, Weapon Switch had a cooldown, but after successfully transforming it into a passive skill, now the skill permanently reduced all weapon switching cooldowns by 30%. Chung opened his backpack, surveying an array of beginner weapons. Long swords, short swords, daggers, hammers, axes, and more. With the new passive ability, he realized he could swiftly switch between these weapons during combat, enhancing his flexibility and strategy. Chung's lips curved into a satisfied smile as he opened his character panel, revealing detailed information. The panel displayed his name, race, and level, currently at level 1. He was just 100 experience points away from leveling up. His attributes, strength, agility, intellect, and vitality, each stood at 20 points. Each attribute impacted different aspects of his abilities. Strength influenced physical attack power, agility affected critical hit rate, evasion, and attack speed. Intellect influenced mana regeneration and spell damage, and vitality affected health and stamina. Chung had two passive skills, Wave Slash and Weapon Transformation, with a combat rating of 500. Ready to head out, Chung exited the practice area. He stepped through the portal, ready for the next day's assessment. The day arrived quickly and the hall was packed with spectators. Thousands of students stood in the center, fully armed and ready, all waiting for their chance to awaken their talents. Close to Chung, two students were checking their weapons and potions. Suddenly, Li Hong's voice rang out from behind. He ran towards Cheng, holding something in his hand. Using the power of money, Li Hong had convinced his father to bribe someone and acquire the map of today's assessment. Last night, Chung had messaged Li Hong to try his best to obtain more intel for the assessment. Though puzzled, Li Hong had obliged. Li Hong's voice was quite lewd, prompting Chung to tell him to lower his voice. Li Hong immediately covered his mouth and then quietly shared his excitement. They moved to a corner where Li Hong unfolded the map, revealing that today's assessment would take place in the Ragefire Chasm, chosen by the most strict of them all, Professor Liu. Li Hong believed the difficulty of this secret realm would be high, given Professor Liu's reputation for rigor. After hearing about the Ragefire Chasm in the back of his mind, Cheng was familiar with this novice map where monster levels ranged from 3 to 10, not too difficult for him. However, for Li Hong at his current level, it would be a challenge. Cheng turned to Li Hong, asking him about the highest level of elite monsters he had managed to solo in the novice secret realm. With a hint of embarrassment, Li Hong fiddled with his fingers and sheepishly admitted that 5 was probably his limit. Chung sighed internally at Li Hong's lack of strength and prepared to use some shortcuts to help his friend. However, their conversation had attracted unwanted attention. A blonde-haired boy named Mao Feng, flanked by two sidekicks, approached with a mocking tone. He ridiculed Li Hong for trying to take shortcuts because of his wealth, then began to make fun of his dad. Mao Feng, a rich brat from the neighboring class, whose father was a direct business rival to Li Hong's father, always looked for ways to undermine Li Hong. Infuriated, Li Hong rolled up his sleeves, not willing to let it slide. Chung, noticing the anger in his best friend's eyes, quickly stopped him, urging him to stay calm. Li Hong protested, eager to put Mao Feng in his place. Mao Feng, energized by Li Hong's anger, taunted them further, saying Chung was wise to hold Li Hong back, knowing he couldn't win. Just then, Chung subtly tripped Mao Feng with a swift move of his foot, causing him to fall face first to the ground, eliciting laughter from the surrounding crowd. Li Hong was also shocked. Cheng quipped, telling Mao Feng there was no need for such a grand apology. Mao Feng made a fool of himself in front of everyone and stood up, his face red from earlier embarrassment. He glared at Cheng hatefully, never having imagined Cheng, who used to be unnoticeable, would dare to take the initiative against him. Seeking his own death, he cursed, then swung a punch at Cheng, but to his surprise, Cheng caught it effortlessly with one hand. Mao Feng, regaining his composure and pondering Cheng's surprising strength, listened as Cheng proposed a bet. After Cheng let go of him, Mao Feng rubbed his sore wrist and scoffed at the wager. It turned out that Cheng said the wager was to see whether Li Hong would score higher than Mao Feng in the assessment. The noisy crowd around them fell silent at this bold challenge. Mao Feng and his sidekick couldn't help but burst into laughter, finding the bet absurdly easy. Mao Feng disdainfully agreed, setting the stakes. The loser would run 10 laps around the field but naked and shout 3 times that the winner was their father. Cheng smiled and accepted the bet, causing Li Hong, drenched in cold sweat, to simply stare at his best friend in disbelief, speechless. The audacity of the bet shocked everyone, including the teachers maintaining order. The gap in ability between Li Hong and Mao Feng was well known. One was the worst student, the other a top performer. After the trio left, Li Hong became anxious, whispering his concerns to Cheng. Cheng gestured reassuringly, but Li Hong was close to tears, lamenting his simple wish to pass the assessment and impress his father. Not expecting such a turn of events, he clearly had no confidence in himself. Cheng watched Li Hong's frustrated expression, holding back his laughter, and then pulled him up, whispering a plan into his ear. No one other than Li Hong could hear what Cheng said, but Li Hong's expression transformed from panic to surprise, and then to overwhelming excitement. He eagerly asked Cheng if it was possible, to which Cheng nodded with a smile. Li Hong then stood up, shouting that today he would make Mao Feng run laps while calling him daddy. The crowd watched utterly bewildered by this bold declaration. Then, a middle-aged man approached the center of the stadium, drawing everyone's attention by coughing into the mic. He was the dean, a second-class transfer professional. Without missing a beat, he announced the start of the assessment. As the candidates entered the portal one after another, Li Hong flexed his biceps before stepping in confidently, telling Cheng to watch his performance. As it was Cheng's turn, a flash of white light transported him into the Rage Fire Chasm. The heat in the secret realm was intense, with lava everywhere. The familiar environment of the massive volcanic cave, rumored to be the dwelling of evil orcs and demons, stretched out before him. The front part of the chasm consisted of several small platforms suspended above the lava, connected by narrow pathways where one misstep could mean falling into the scorching molten rock. To reach the final boss of this map, players had to climb rugged mountains. "It feels good to be back in a novice secret realm," Cheng mused, rubbing his wrists. Taking a deep breath, Cheng quickly moved deeper into the secret realm. Following the route he remembered, he soon encountered 2 monsters, grotesque, muscular, green-skinned orcs known as Burning Blade Acolytes, armed with sharp daggers. The moment their eyes met, the acolytes charged at him. The sudden attack startled Cheng, but he easily dodged it by leaping backward. However, 3 more appeared behind him, quickly surrounding him. Experiencing it in real life was different from playing on a computer. Now, unlike controlling the keyboard, this was a real physical battle. Cheng pulled a beginner's sword from his backpack. The monster's speed and strength were notably greater than the weakened creatures he had faced in the practice arena. Surrounded by the 5 monstrous orcs, Cheng realized that fighting 1 against 5 was a daunting task. Suddenly, the system notified him that his vast gaming experience had been converted into instinctual bodily responses. Cheng was surprised, thinking even this could be turned into a passive ability. He felt a remarkable change in his body, as if a surge of strength had filled his muscles and bones. What he could do in the game was made into muscle memory. As 2 orcs lunged at him, Cheng dodged with uncanny agility. Then he leaped an astonishing distance onto a wall. Using the wall for leverage, he propelled himself back towards the orcs, delivering a powerful kick to one of them, sending it flying several meters away. The orcs were momentarily stunned, and with his sword in hand, Cheng felt a rush of excitement, adapting to his newfound capabilities. This transformation ability was incredible. He could control every muscle in his body with precision. He coldly eyed the remaining orcs, now confident in his newfound prowess, and taunted them to attack together. Sensing Cheng's challenge, the 5 orcs charged at him in unison. Cheng masterfully dodged their attacks, skillfully maneuvering them into a line. Seizing the opportunity, he executed a swift, sliding tackle, sending all 5 orcs into the air. Then, turning swiftly, he unleashed Wave Slash. In an instant, a burst of purple light emanated from his sword, forming a circular wave that struck all the airborne orcs. But it didn't end there. The passive Wave Slash triggered, unleashing an even more potent attack. The combination of the active and passive wave slash was devastating. The five burning blade acolytes were obliterated, their bodies crashing heavily to the ground. Since Chung performed what the system called a special move to defeat the orcs, he was rewarded with a 50% experience bonus, amassing a total of 250 experience points. This rapid gain propelled him straight to level 3, and his body was enveloped in two golden glows of level-up excitement sparkled in Chung's eyes. The additional experience from a special kill was an unexpected boon. Defeating just five monsters had catapulted him to level 3. This world is much more intriguing than the game, he thought, feeling increasingly engaged with this new reality. He continued his journey deeper into the secret realm, contemplating the numerous tactics he could employ with his array of beginner skills and weapons. Meanwhile, back in the assessment hall, a large screen displayed the information of all participants. The rankings on the screen were constantly changing. Suddenly, a name that shot up to level 3 captured everyone's attention. It was none other than Chung. Students from the first and second years watched the screen in excitement, amazed to see someone level up twice in less than 5 minutes. Even the dean also noticed the leaderboard. The name Chung only vaguely registered with him, sparking curiosity about what other surprises the student might bring back in the secret realm. Chung swiftly navigated several platforms until something caught his eye at a corner, prompting him to halt. He spotted a few cloaked figures not far ahead, three shadow mages, each accompanied by a hunting hound. Chung scanned the area, and a brilliant idea struck him. He recalled a bug from his past gaming experiences that, if exploited successfully, could simplify leveling up significantly quickly. He took out a grappling hook gun and fired it upwards, landing atop a large boulder with a commanding view of the mages below. He then pulled out a small dart and threw it at one of the shadow mages. The dart didn't cause much damage, but it drew the attention and pulled the aggro of all three mages as they looked up and began to cast spells. Their progress bars for shadow bolts slowly filled. Chung stepped back and hid behind the rock, knowing that low-level shadow mages only had two skills, summoning hunting hounds and casting shadow bolts. He was confident his plan would work. With Chung out of their line of sight, their cast was interrupted, and their progress bars reset. Chung was happy with how things were going as planned, pleased with the effectiveness of his strategy to exploit their line of sight. He then resumed his attack, throwing more darts to eliminate the mages' hounds before retreating back behind the rock, causing another interruption. Then, an amusing scene unfolded. With their hounds killed, the mages simultaneously began summoning new ones. Chung couldn't help but feel exhilarated as his plan was working perfectly. He had remembered an infamous novice bug, the Shadow Warlock summoning glitch. The glitch occurred when the mages, unable to lock onto a target, fell into a logical error, continuously summoning hounds. Each summoned hound added to the potential experience points, as the summoned creatures also yielded experience upon defeat. Chung flawlessly executed this strategy, exploiting the bug to its fullest. Now, all he had to do was wait for the right moment to strike. He laid down, deciding to take a brief rest while the mages unwittingly accumulated massive experience points for him. 8 hours swiftly passed in the assessment hall, and the leaderboard underwent significant changes. Chung's name had long disappeared from the top, with the first and second places occupied by students at level 9. The rest of the top 10 were at level 8, and those who followed were students at levels higher. Li Hong was ranked 498th. Having reached level 4, students buzzed with discussions, particularly disappointed in Chung, who had initially reached level 3 faster than anyone else, but was now at the very bottom, still at level 3. As time ticked away, the first student finally reached level 10 and successfully transferred his class. It was Jing Jing, who had been in second place. She suddenly surged to level 10, becoming the first to class change to a gunner, jumping to the top of the leaderboard. The crowd erupted into cheers, but the excitement was short-lived as more students reached level 10 and began their class transfers, with several becoming swordsmen. The dean nodded in satisfaction at the progress of these outstanding students. However, his expression turned to disappointment when he saw Chung's name still lingering at the bottom. The onlookers began to mock Chung, speculating that his initial rapid ascent to level 3 was just a fluke. The consensus was that if Chung were truly skilled, he wouldn't have remained in an ordinary classroom for 3 years. The dean, with a tinge of regret, noted that the secret realm would only remain open for 12 hours, and with just over 3 hours left, the best Chung could hope for was reaching level 6, considering the final boss was still far off. The dean doubted Chung's ability to awaken his talent. Just as the spectators were discussing Chung's perceived failure, A student suddenly shouted, "Look, the last place is moving!" Everyone turned their eyes to the big screen, and their expressions changed drastically. Chung rapidly climbed from last place to 400th, then to 200th, and soon to 120th. The dean's eyes widened in disbelief, unable to comprehend how Chung managed to level up so quickly. To know what had happened, let's rewind to a few minutes earlier. No joke, Chung had actually slept for 8 hours. He was just waking up. He stretched comfortably, then stood up, glancing casually below the boulder. His eyelids twitched in shock. The platform was swarming with at least 400 mobs under him, and the number continued to increase. Chung was delighted as he pulled out a Gatling gun, aiming at the shadow mages below. Excitedly, he pondered how many levels he could gain from such a multitude of hounds. As he began firing the gun, the world came to life, spraying bullets wildly at the unsuspecting targets. Though each bullet inflicted minimal damage, the sheer volume of fire was devastating. Soon, one warlock fell, followed by the rapid disappearance of the hounds. Then, the other two mages succumbed as well. With the field cleared of hounds, golden light erupted from Chung, and his experience points skyrocketed, reflected in the frantic system notification. Chung watched his experience points rapidly increase, a satisfied smile on his face. Now this is how to level up, he thought. Taking them down one by one would have been too tiring. As Chung's level increased, so did his skills. Wave Slash's damage multiplier went from 1.5 times to 16 times, and his invincibility period extended from 0.2 seconds to 3 seconds. Cooldown reduction for weapon switch also improved, now permanently reducing the cooldown by 40%. Chung, exhilarated, gazed at his skill bar, pondering if his passive skills might eventually trigger 100% of the time at higher levels. The notification of leveling up flickered continuously. Incredibly, in less than a minute, Chung had skyrocketed to level 13 through his strategic massacre of the mages and their hounds. On the leaderboard outside, his name now soared above the former first place, marking him as the first person to reach level 13. Meanwhile, the teachers observing from outside were utterly captivated by Chung's meteoric rise on the big screen. My goodness, what kind of leveling speed is this? In just a few seconds, he's jumped over 100 ranks. The rise continues. It's unbelievable. How did he manage this? I've never seen or heard of anything like this in all my years. Chung's achievement was so remarkable that it would likely rank in the top 3 nationally. All these comments began to pour in, and the teachers were stunned by Chung's sudden ascent. However, one plump teacher beamed with pride, pointing at himself and excitedly claiming Chung was from his class. Though he didn't understand how Chung, a student known only for decent grades, had achieved such a feat, he didn't miss the chance to boast. His joyous laughter was cut short when he sensed someone behind him. Turning around, he found himself facing the dean. The dean, infuriated, berated him for not recognizing such a talented student earlier. How could you miss such a gem right under your nose? The teacher didn't dare to speak up, while the dean shook his head in regret at the admission of his oversight, murmuring to himself about how he too didn't recognize such a prodigy earlier. In the back of his mind, he was certain that Chung's talents were unprecedented in the school's history. Back in the secret realm, the system voice echoed in Chung's ears as another notification popped up, congratulating him for reaching level 13. Now, he could choose his desired profession in class. Chung paused, considering his options. In his previous life, he had reached the pinnacle in all professions and acquired their divine titles, except for one path, the classless vagrant, a unique playstyle that involved not choosing any class. The advantages and disadvantages of being a classless vagrant were distinct. One major advantage was the ability to use any equipment without class restrictions, offering immense versatility and gear combinations. Classless vagrants could tailor their gear to perfectly match their combat style. Additionally, they retained all basic skills, as other classes would automatically abandon other branches' basic skills upon class transfer. This allowed the classless vagrant the greatest freedom. However, classless vagrants never caught on, mainly due to a critical issue: their insufficient damage output. Their multitude of basic skills, limited by not class transferring, couldn't be overcome, even by someone as skilled as Chung. But now, in this new world with the transformative passive system, Chung realized he could address the classless vagrant's fatal flaw. With his experience and technique, he could maximize the potential of a classless vagrant. The choice was clear. Chung chose the path of the classless vagrant, ready to rectify his past regrets. Then, another system notification appeared. Congratulations on successfully choosing the classless vagrant's unique hidden class, the Spellbinder. Before we continue, let's take a moment to shout out at Aniketh underscore DeltaFrost 8143, who commented, "The way you narrated it was so good, bro," on our Killer Peter video. Thanks for commenting. In the assessment hall, students and teachers alike were abuzz with speculation about what class Chung would choose. When the screen displayed that Chung had selected the classless vagrant, a class considered to be weak and useless, the crowd was shocked. The dean roared in disbelief and angrily confronted Chung's class teacher, questioning his teaching methods. And how could his student choose such a useless class? Classless vagrants were universally regarded as having no future in this world, a consensus that no one believed could change. The classroom teacher was more anxious than anyone. He explained that Chung had always shown an inclination towards the berserker class in tests and career preference surveys. The dean, after hearing his explanation, calmed down slightly, rubbing his forehead in contemplation. It seemed that Chung had indeed intended to follow the berserker path until his sudden, inexplicable change of heart, which the dean attributed to youthful impulsiveness and obstinacy. The assessment hall was filled with a sense of shock and sadness at the perceived downfall of a prodigy. The lower grade students, unable to comprehend the choice, discussed among themselves. One knowledgeable student explained that while classless vagrants have great freedom and versatility in early levels, they fall drastically behind other classes in the mid to late stages, becoming the weakest link in any team. Meanwhile, Chung, unaware of the commotion he had caused, was content with his progress. Having reached level 13, his power had increased significantly. He was satisfied with his class choice, confident that the passive transformation system would address the classless vagrant's critical damage deficiency. With his experience and skills, he was ready to maximize the potential of the classless vagrant. Upon opening his information panel, Chung encountered the term Spellbinder and clicked for an explanation. The Spellbinder class is a hidden branch of the classless vagrant. It couldn't learn skills from any other institutions, but only from boss drops. However, each level up granted an extra 2 attribute points. Additionally, secret realms were set to the highest difficulty by default, with increased rewards for completion. Chung was astounded by these perks, initially shocked but quickly understanding how suiting this was. With his intimate knowledge of all secrets and their layouts, this class was perfect for him. He tapped his chest, thinking, "This class is incredible." After organizing his thoughts, Chung decided that his primary objective was to enhance his passive damage by increasing attack speed. Consequently, he allocated all his free attribute points to agility. After doing so, his speed became incredibly fast. The monsters couldn't even see him before they were sliced into pieces. Chung felt a tremendous improvement in attack speed, dodge frequency, and critical hit rate. Focusing all his attributes on agility made his dodging and attacking more effortless and fluid, a tangible improvement in physical capabilities rather than just a numerical increase. This transformation exhilarated Chung. During his rapid progress, an old book was dropped from the corpse of a burning blade acolyte, drawing his attention. Intrigued by the title Book of Demons on the cover, Chung opened the book and began to read. As he did, old memories surfaced in his mind, reminding him of an interesting hidden task in the secret realm. Other than the final boss, there were also hidden bosses summonable only by collecting specific items. However, with only 1 hour left until the end of the assessment, time was of the essence. Chung quickly decided to pursue this hidden boss. If successful, it could be the key to unlocking new abilities and further elevating his power. As the assessment neared its conclusion, many students had reached level 10. They gathered at the area of the final boss, Zalan, preparing for the ultimate challenge. This was the decisive moment of the assessment. Defeating Zalan and successfully awakening meant a promising future, while failure could mean a lifetime of mediocrity. Zalan, a level 10 elite boss, was a formidable opponent with exceptional attributes. With his massive ram horns and blood-red skin, he was a quintessential demonic beast. Only by defeating him and touching the awakening stone behind him would the candidates pass the assessment. Guarding Zalan were 2 powerful bodyguards, adding to the challenge. Among the candidates, one student, battle-worn and exhausted, with his clothes scorched and tattered, breathed heavily, steeling himself for the fight. "Just defeat him, and I'll awaken," he thought, charging towards Zalan with a weapon in hand. What will happen next? Find out next time by staying tuned for our future recaps. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more great recaps.